If you're new to this channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to be continuing on with our coupon functionality. And where we left off last time was to be able to enter our promo code right in this section right here and to have it be acknowledged on the front end through a die and dump. So let's go and work on that now. In here, we are going to need to head into the coupon controller and go down to our store function. The first thing that I want to do is right here, this code variable, I just want to change it to coupon code. We don't actually need this parentheses right here. And the next thing that I want to add is the discount. We're going to use the coupon variable. And then we are going to be using the discount function that we created. And that discount function, we are going to pass in the subtotal that we're getting from the cart. Now, this discount function right here, if we go to our coupon model, that's what this discount function is right here. It's bringing in the relationship of couponable, and it's attaching the discount, and it's passing in the value that we're putting in, which is the subtotal. Now, instead of this die and dump, what I want to do is I want to put our coupon in the session. We're going to give it a coupon key. We're going to give it a name. And that name is going to be the coupon code. And the discount is going to equal discount. Then we can just return back. Now, before we get this to display, I want to make some changes in our cart controller. So we have the tax, the items, all of that is fine. The subtotal is fine. This cart subtotal, I want to keep this one up here. So the first thing that I want to do in here is I want to bring in the code and then I want to bring in the discount. So we'll go ahead and put that right under here. Code equals session, and then we're going to go ahead and get the coupon key that we have, and for the code we're using the name key for that. Then we're going to copy paste, and we're going to do the same for discount. Now let's go ahead and pass that into the prop. Let's go ahead and accept it in the page. And it's the cart index page. So here we need the code. And we need the discount. Let's pass it into the prop. We're going to accept it in the component. Okay, which means now we can head up top and scroll down a little bit. Now we can put the code where it's displaying the discount code. And then here we're going to put the discount, but we need the filter for it. And that should be good for right now. Let's go ahead and check the browser. Go ahead and refresh, and we're going to get some errors, so we'll just deal with them one at a time. Trying to access array offset on value of type null, and that's with the get coupon name, and that's because we haven't tried to put in a coupon yet, but we do need to fix that. So if we head back into the cart controller, so that name we can do, if we don't have a name, we'll leave it null. We'll try it again. And we have another one, which is the discount. So since that is an integer, we're just going to go ahead and put zero. Let's try it again. Cool. So we have a discount code, but it is $0 because, well, we haven't put one in yet. So let's try to put one in. We'll start with the first one, which is the percent off. Okay, so we have the ABC 123, and then we have the percent off, the dollar amount off of the percentage, because the discount code is 10% off of 1940, which is $1.94. Fantastic. Now, one thing I want to do is, once we put in a coupon code, I don't want this to display here. Let's go ahead and fix that first. We head over to order totals, and we go down to that section right under here. We can put VIF no code, because we only want it to display when there's no code. So hopefully this should be gone. Okay, cool. Now, before we get into adjusting this, what I want to do is I want to create the delete function for this to remove it from our session. So let's go handle that. For that, we need a new route. And we'll just copy paste this one. This one will be delete. Store and store will be destroy. Okay, let's go ahead and add this function to the controller. Down to the destroy method. And for this, since we put something in the session, all we have to do here is to forget it. Then we can just return back. Okay, let's go ahead and put that in the order totals component. We'll start with the form, which is right. Filters, discount. Form. Okay, so we'll do at submit prevent equals delete coupon, and let's go ahead add that method down below. Delete coupon, this will be delete, this will be destroy. Preserve scroll we can keep, this form reset we don't need, and coupon has been removed. Let's try this. Okay, so now if we click this, it should be back down here. Okay, cool. So it's back down here. And I also want to get rid of it from up here when there's no discount code in there. So right where we're displaying the code, right here, this whole section right here, we can just do VIF code. Okay, so now that that's gone, let's go ahead and start working on some of these numbers, because I know we need to change these values. So let's head into the cart controller, and I can close out the web.php and coupons. I think we're done in here. We can close this as well. Fantastic. So there are some things that I want to change in here. There's a lot of these because I really wanted to just have us to be able to display something. We're going to keep most of it, but some of these we're going to take out or just change. Cart items is fine. Cart tax rate is fine. The tax is fine. The subtotal is fine. So what I want to do is I want to create a new variable, and we're going to call it new subtotal. Keep in mind, we're going to be using the subtotal. This is from the cart, and we're going to be using that to display that up here. This is going to be where the new subtotal goes once we use the discount and everything. And then our tax is going to go up here, and our entire total is going to be different here. So that's why we need three different variables for that. Okay, so the new subtotal is going to be the cart subtotal variable minus the discount. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these two and I'm going to bring them up just so that we have some structure to this. New subtotal is going to be the cart subtotal, which is this right here, minus the discount. So it's either going to have a value or it's going to be zero. Now, since we're going to be having new values based on the discount, we're going to need a new tax or a new cart tax. So instead of cart tax, we'll say new tax, and that will equal the new subtotal times the tax property that we have up here, the variable, And then we also need a different new total because this is the total coming from the shopping cart without any discounts or anything in it. So this new subtotal is now going to be new subtotal times the tax. Now, what's going to happen is once we do that, it's going to give us an off number. So let's say the tax is 1.65. It's going to give us 1.655551, whatever it is. Okay, so what we want to do here is we want to add 1. And that'll give us a more balanced, more rounded number. Okay, so now in here we need cart tax will now be new tax. We have the subtotal, the cart subtotal. We have the code discount. We need the new subtotal. We have our new total and everything else should be good. Let's make sure that we have all of these on the front end. Let me just grab these so I don't forget what they are. We're going to bring them into the index. And I'm just temporarily pasting them here. Okay, so we have cart items. We can get rid of this one. Cart tax rate. Cart subtotal. Cart tax is now new tax. We have code discount. New subtotal. And new total. So all of that stuff should be correct. Get rid of that. Let me copy these. And we need to pass these into the component. Cart tax rate. Subtotal is cart subtotal. Tax. Is new tax. Total, new total, new sub total. Everything else is fine. Let's go ahead, get rid of that. Let's grab this one and make sure we have these in the order totals component. Okay, so tax rate, subtotal, we have those. Tax, total. And all we need in here is the new subtotal. Okay, let's go ahead and get rid of this. And let's work our way from the top to the bottom and clean this up. Okay, so this is fine. The subtotal is the correct one from here. Subtotal, this is going to be the new subtotal. Shipping is free. Discount is fine. Tax will be fine. This should be new subtotal, or sorry, new total. Tax rate is fine. And I think I wanted to get rid of the estimated tax. Since we're using a dollar amount, we don't need this percent. And everything else should be the same. Let's go to the browser and check it out. Okay, so we have not a number and not a number. What's that? The subtotal and the total. Let's see what's up. Okay, for one, I think this is lowercase. So we'll start there. New subtotal. And let's check these. New subtotal. New subtotal. Let's try that. Okay, that fixed that. And let's see what's going on with our total. New total, total. I think I put new total here. This can just stay total. And let's check and make sure. Yep. Okay, let's try that. Okay, cool. So now if we take a look and we have 19.40 plus 1.65 and our total is 2105 and our tax should be correct. Let's check it. It should be 19.40 times 8.48 divided by 100, 1.65 and 1.65. That's the average. That's fine. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and try to add a coupon. This is going to be the 10% off coupon. Okay, so let's just do a quick sanity check. As I said, 10% off. So 1.94 is 10% of 1940. So we'll do 19.40 minus 1.94 4, and that gives us our subtotal up here. And then our new tax, which is $1.48, we'll add that. And 1894 is our total. Let's just do a quick sanity check and make sure that tax is correct. 8.48 divided by 100. And then we multiply that by the new subtotal, which is 1.48. And that is correct. That's what the tax is. Let's try it with the dollar off. So we'll remove this. And then it's DEF456. Okay, so now we have a bit of a problem here. Our item starts off with $19.40. We just took off $20. Our numbers are all kinds of janky. Okay, we have a minus 60 cent subtotal and then the tax off of that, which is all negative, and it shouldn't be negative. So to avoid this, what we need to do is have a check in our controller. Head over to the cart controller. Under this new subtotal we have here, we're going to do if the new subtotal is less than zero, then we'll just say the new subtotal will equal zero. And let's go see if that gives us the correct values. This was our subtotal. This is the new subtotal. We took off the $20 and 0000. Fantastic. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to push all the code up to GitHub and leave a link for that down in the description, as well as a link to the playlist so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.